40 standing and 50 and even 100 years. These were awards of Erwin Kahneman, a former head of state of East Germany. But less than a year later, the Berlin Wall fell and two divided countries became one Germany. Just imagine if the same would happen for a 38th parallel. Like Germany, a democratic republic and a communist state reunited peacefully to become one country. Hello, my name is Shuni Choi, and I, for one, hope for the peaceful reunification of North and South Korea. There are many critics who believe that reunification is unavoidable, and there are many critics who are against reunification, but personally, I believe there are many benefits for both countries. First, if you're from South Korea, you would know that all foreign vacations are impossible without place. But what if North Korea opens up a southern border? We will be able to travel to China, Russia, India, and even all the way to the countries of Europe by automobile or train. If North and South Korea reunify, many families will plan the once-in-a-lifetime vacations. Imagine a two-month trip by automobile from Seoul all the way to the American people of Germany. You could start a journey with a traditional breakfast with rice and kimchi, and end the trip with a German pastries for dessert. The travel will take place, but it will still be the most epic vacation ever. Secondly, many people already know that life in North Korea is very difficult. Most people live without proper food or electricity, and many are forced to become laborers for the government. According to the United Nations, there are nearly 120,000 people working in North Korean labor camps. Most suffer from starvation, and many of them are executed without a trial. Yeon Mi Park, a North Korean defector, once told a frightening story during the New York Times interview. When she was 13 years old, she witnessed a man executed in public. The victim was shot to death by soldiers while her family and neighbors were forced to watch. Deprived for the punishment? Watching a South Korean TV show. Think about it, it's too harsh and cruel for their punishment. If North and South Korea are reunified, the standard of living of North Koreans would increase. Not only that, but as part of North Korea, we could force the North to treat their citizens more humanely. Lastly, to people like my teacher's grandmother, reunification doesn't simply mean a reunified country, but mean a reunited family. On June 25, 1950, Kim Il-sung decided to invade South Korea. 3 years later, one country became two, and many families were torn apart. These Isan Gajo, or divided families, are not strangers. For many Koreans sitting in the audience, they are our mothers and fathers, our sisters and brothers. They are you and me. According to the U.S. government, there are about 500,000 Koreans living in America who have family in North Korea. And that's just in the U.S. alone. Unfortunately, only 80 people have successfully made contact. In conclusion, I believe the reunification of North and South Korea would be beneficial for both countries. These days, many people are skeptical about reunification, and some don't even find it necessary. Sometimes, when I eat delicious ice cream and watch my favorite TV show in my air conditioned room, I begin to feel the same way. Why should I care about reunification? But immediately, I remind myself of the millions of people, family, and nurse. My teacher's grandmother often repeats to her grandchildren, "My only wish is to see my younger sister before I die, so I cannot leave this world until I do." This year, she will be 94 years old. So, whether you're a supporter of North Koreans wanting a better life, or just a traveler dreaming of adventure, please consider the benefits of reunification. Of course, it will take time, but let's make sure the 38th parallel doesn't last for another 50 or even 100 years. Thank you.
This is Nanda Jun's.